Welcome to the Mabee Center, and the excitement will continue. There was a terrific girls game in front of this as Claremore wins the 5A state title, and J.B. Haney, I don't think we'll have anything less as Bartlesville and their Twin Towers takes on Edmond Santa Fe.
Well, this is going to be an interesting matchup, Rick, from the standpoint that we talked earlier, the fact that Bartlesville plays a more controlled game. They play a more deliberate game. They don't get up and down quite as fast, but they got the two big guys inside. They really depend on sometimes the perimeter shooting isn't as good as Coach Bart would like, but Santa Fe looked awfully good here yesterday.
Well, it's when you take a look at Bartlesville in the first round game that we did, it was Jacob Brosda that actually was the hero, and he, as they said in the newspaper the next day, is their fifth option. If the Twin Towers aren't scoring today, is it a Brosda? Is it a Rovenstein? Who's the guy that takes up the slack?
Well, someone's got to take up the slack, and I think it's going to be Rovenstein who's going to have to do it. But keep in mind, defensively, you've got to look at Manello. He was so great yesterday, doing everything that you could think of, and then getting some big help out of Haymaker inside. And they've got the Twin Towers themselves inside, so it's just going to be a type of ball game that you would just like to sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Well, of course, added to the broadcast today, a man who knows an awful lot about basketball. He's got a pretty good jump shot himself. Chris Plank is on the sidelines. Let's find out what Chris is thinking right about now. Chris?
Well, unfortunately, I'm undersized, Rick, but Edmond Santa Fe may not be. They understand that Bartlesville might have the height advantage and they want to control the tempo in this game. But as JV pointed out, don't be surprised to see Edmond Santa Fe try to run. And I don't know if you can tell by the noise, but we've got a great environment here at the Mabee Center right now. Edmond Santa Fe's fans already warned by security twice, so you know this thing is going to be fun, guys.
Well, the Bartlesville group, I think, as we said the other day, I think the last person out of the city had to turn the lights off, Coach, because they're all over here behind us, and we've got some great statistics about how many people travel down here. But, you know, I guess you take a look at it. You've coached in a situation like this before. This is a city, and it's not a small, tiny city, but it's not a huge city. This is their chance.
Well, you know, most of the teams that come from outside the metropolitan areas, it is something big in the lives of the community, and it is in Bartlesville. This has been this way for years. It kind of got down for a while, but Tim Bart's done such a marvelous job of bringing the Bruins back to state prominence, and you're right. They just close things down. The entire community comes to watch their Bruins play.
But if you take a look at their lineup, Noah Hartsock, who is, of course, their biggest star, he is only a junior. However, Sam Mitchell, the other tower, is a senior. Ben Rovenstein, kind of their leader, is a senior. Ryan Waters, a senior as well. Let's take a look at the Edmond Santa Fe Wolves starting five. Left guard, number 11, Andy Shaw. Now, watch Andy Shaw. He's a young man that hurt himself yesterday, had a shoulder wrap, but came back in later on, a 6'1" junior. The other guard, number 15, Chance Hardiker, 5'10" junior, and he is the coach's son. Guy Hardiker is his father. Here's the guy you want to watch. At forward, number 32, Obi Manello, a 6'5" junior who's already getting letters, coach, from all over the country from just about every school.
Well, those he has not gotten letters from, he will after this summer in AAU basketball.
That's probably the case. The other forward, number 21, Epe Udo, a 6'9" junior, and then another forward. They list him at a forward, really plays the post position. Number 50, Drew Haymaker, a 6'8" junior for the Edmond Santa Fe Wolves. Five juniors, coach. That's a team that'll be back, and there's their head coach, Guy Hardiker.
And what a great job Guy Hardiker has done with this young ball club. And, you know, I've said this yesterday, Drew Haymaker, I think, is such a pivotal a position that he plays for the Wolves, that he's a very, very key ingredient.
All right, now let's take a look at the Bartlesville starting five. At guard, number 11, Ryan Waters. He's a 5'9" senior. Here's their quarterback, really, Ben Rovenstein. He's a 6'3" senior guard. And, coach, this is a guy that really should play a two. He's had to play the one this year, the point, and done a good job.
He really has, and I'll tell you what he's done. He's moved the ball. He's been able to get the ball in the movement, to get the ball inside to both to Mitchell and to Hartsock, and that's his job. He's done a good job of it.
Now, Jacob Brosda at forward, number 32, 6'2", junior. This is the guy that was the wild card, had 15-plus points in the opening round, or second round, pardon me, and this is a guy who only averages about 7 a game, and he almost doubled that. Sam Mitchell and Noah Hartsock are the Twin Towers. Mitchell, number 45, a 6'9 senior, and Hartsock, a 6'8 junior, number 34. And again, Tim Bart says the best scorer he has ever coached. Tell me what Hartsock does well after you talk about Tim Bart.
Well, first of all, you know, when Tim Bart came to Bartlesville, every place he has gone since he's coached, in just a couple of years, there's been a dramatic change. He has really brought the Bruins back, as we said, to state prominence. But when you look at Noah Hartsock, the center, you know, he shoots such a great percentage. He's 62% from the inside the arc, and he goes outside and shoots 33%. So he's the type of player that not only can play with his back to the basket, but he'll take you outside and whip you there, which makes him a great college prospect.
And great soft hands. We've seen a very soft touch from him, haven't we?
Well, and you talk about soft touch. Everyone is talking about the softer ends and maybe center. I don't know where that is really true. I think it is because the kids feel like, hey, I can hit the basket here. And they put it up, and it seems like it floats in.
Well, J.B. Haney talked a moment ago about Tim Barton and how he has resurrected programs. He did that at Moore. That's, of course, who they had played in the opening round. But before he came to Bartlesville, the year before, the Bruins were 2-21. Since that time, 96-34. Last year, lost to the quarters, and now, of course, all the way to the final. So I'd call that a pretty good job.
That's a great turnabout. He did the same thing at Will Rogers High School here in Tulsa after he left Moore. He did this identical same thing. So he really has his focus in. He knows how to get the best out of kids. He knows how to put them in the proper position. And as a result of it, he's extremely successful.
Well, and as Chris Plank said, and we will hear from Chris during this game, this atmosphere is something. You look across the way, and an awful lot of folks from Edmond had Pike passes out today, didn't they?
You know, the gold section of the Mabee Center is just almost completely filled, and that makes for a great atmosphere. But, Rick, we were talking earlier. I think it's going to be so important to see how these guys react coming off the semifinal game because it is different today. It's different from the coaching standpoint. It's different from the player's standpoint to be able to step in here and play in front of a great crowd for the 6A championship. And keep in mind that Santa Fe has never won a state title. So those kids are really, they've got a lot of weight on their shoulders today.
Now, something we talked about yesterday, and it may be even more accentuated today, is you get that excitement in the first minute or minute and a half of the game. You just wear yourself out. You expect to see some of that and then maybe a settling in?
Well, I think we call that second wind sometimes, don't we?
Yep.
Because you go out and you are just so fired up. The adrenaline is just rushing through your body. Once you kind of get through that, then you settle back in. Of course, in the state championship, if you don't settle back in very quickly, you may be so far behind you can.
All right, now one of the things that we noticed about Obi Manello as well, and he's number 32 for Edmond Santa Fe. They are in the green jerseys and the green shorts. Of course, Bartlesville in their robin's egg blue, or I guess we just say light blue. They probably wouldn't want me to call it that with the darker blue trim. Watch Manello, he will create. And let's get it underway at the Mabee Center, the 6A boys state title game, and the tip goes to the Wolves. Chance Hardiker, the coach's son, and usually that's the guy that runs your offense, Coach.
And you know, he really does a good job of getting things set up, keeping the floor balanced, and moving the ball to the area it needs to go.
You are seeing a little bit of Drew Haymaker outside, and he will do that. They'll put him outside, and he has taken that shot a time or two.
And Bartlesville opening in a man defense, not the most pressing type man, but just a good, solid man defense with a hand in the, whoever has the basketball hand in his face.
Trying to get the ball inside. They get it inside. Back outside. Hardiker will take the three, and he's got it. So the early lead to the Bruins here in the 6A state title game.
That's a good inside-outside look. Take it in, bring it out, get the open look.
To the middle, we're talking Twin Towers again. They get that down low. Hartsock with the turnaround. We may see a 91-90 game, Coach.
Well, we've seen a lot of that high-low look, and that there was another good example of it. Get it to the big guy on the top. He gives it to his buddy at the bottom.
There's Manello, his first touch of the game, and he'll drive. Wild shot, no good, and Hartsock comes down with the rebound.
And now we're looking at what we're talking about with Bartlesville. You notice then that Ravenstein, he's just not going to push it down real quick. He's going to take his time and do a good job to set up the offense.
Out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Bruins. Ravenstein wearing number 22, wears number 21 in the other jersey. When do they start wearing different home and away jerseys?
I don't know. I never coached at a school that had that
the
much.
Different numbers, right?
Yeah. We had to just keep with one number all the time.
1A and 1B. Bruins, Ravenstein out front. That one taken away, and Manello, when he's on the dribble, look out. Terrific feed to the inside, and Efe Udo gets the score. There's another young man that can jump out of the gym.
Well, you know, I think I can say this truthfully here. In the first 2 minutes of play, I think both teams came ready to play.
I don't think there's any doubt about that. And you better, like you said, in one of these. If you get behind early in one of these, you might not recover. There's Braza. He was the hero in the first round for Bartlesville.
It just seems like he doesn't look too much to score, but we saw him in the first round. He was putting it in from every direction.
Hartsock out front, and now he will take this shot. Obviously, he's got him. Udo is on him right now, but we saw Noah Hartsock hit from out there. Brosdet wide open from three, won't take it. There's Waters to Hartsock. Get that one down, and Hardiker, littlest guy back there, comes down with the board. Off to Manello. There's that dribble penetration. Left hand won't go. Haymaker gets it down. So Edmund Santa Fe with the early 5-point lead.
Well, once again, you see the big fellow in there that Drew Haymaker just getting the good offside rebound, making the easy one.
And hits that one falling away as well. Big guys don't normally have to fade away an awful lot, but he did a good job of it. Brazda looking for an option, and he goes to Rovenstein. A little collision there with Hartsock. Brazda again. Ryan Waters. You hear the crowd behind us chanting boring, or actually I think it's the Edmund fans. Hartsock back to Brazda. Now he took that shot a couple of days ago, coach, and hit it pretty well.
Well, he did. He scored 15 points in the opening game. He only had four in the semifinals, but we saw him yesterday turn down just a number of good shots.
He only shoots around 29% from out there. That one's put up from way outside by Rovenstein. They say he got the line. So the Wolves with a 5-point advantage and just over 4.5 to go, and they'll come this way with the basketball.
And this isn't the type of game that a lot of people maybe expected, but Bartlesville always starts out real slow. If you remember yesterday, they scored more points in the fourth quarter than they did the first three quarters.
Well, and this is basically what they're looking for. Field goal shooting so far, Santa Fe 3 of 5, Bartlesville 1 of 2, so both teams at or above 50%. Hartsock inside to Manello, nice feed. Manello turns it down, but Hartsock won't, and he's got another three down. That's 6 for Hartsock, and an 8-point lead by Edmund Santa Fe. Timeout for Tim Bart and Bartlesville. 10-2 early in this one, just over 4 minutes to go in the first period of the 6A Boys State Championship game. Take a look, JV, at some of what Santa Fe's done so far.
Well, they're taking the ball inside. That was the inside outside coming right, but Hardacre, and he hits it very quickly. That's a good interception, a nice play by Manello in there, taking the ball down very quickly. Udo gets the easy one. And there we saw Manello yesterday doing everything right, but he couldn't get that one down. Good buddy across the way, though, Drew Haymaker. He recovered it and put it in, kind of fading away.
All right, 3-point shooting so far. Santa Fe at 100%. Get much better. 2 of 2. Bartlesville has yet to put one up. Here's a question for you. Are you surprised at all that Bartlesville has Brazda on Manello?
No, not really, because, you know, if he's going to just really concentrate on the defensive end, he won't be thinking maybe as much about offense, but he's a hard-nosed player. I think that's why he probably drew that assignment, Rick.
Rovenstein out front. He'll set it again. And Brosda's going to set. They're going to leave him right there at that 19-foot range. Hartsock acted like he wanted to take it. Well, there's some banging going on inside there, too.
Yes, there is.
Sam Mitchell, who's a little more developed, a little thicker in that upper body, will knock you around. Hartsock fakes like he'll take it, goes underneath the Mitchell. Now there's Brazda, he'll take that one. Can't get it down. And a terrific position play inside by Manello and by Udo.
You know the thing about Chance Hardacre, the middle guard, the point guard here for Santa Fe, hitting those two threes, that really shakes things up to where they can go inside. But you can just tell by the way he handles this ball club that he's a coach on the floor.
By the way, that foul was on Rovenstein, something they'll have to be careful about. Here goes Hardacre again. That one won't go, but how about Manello? He goes back inside twice. Can't get it, and Hartsock's got the rebound. Tim Bart wants his team to slow it down again, and here's what I'm a little surprised at. This really has been more the tempo of Bartlesville. They're still down there.
Well, if you remember yesterday, they trailed, and again, they only scored 21 points in three quarters. They come back in the fourth quarter and score 24 points. So he just kind of plays along with you, but they do have the explosive power to go. But they're not very deep, Rick, and I think that's one of the reasons that they don't want to just really extend themselves all the way.
Nice feed inside. Rovenstein with the driving layup. That ball is blocked. Let's take a look at it here, Coach.
And I tell you what, Rovenstein is much quicker than you think. Very good drive. He kind of faded off, drew the foul, but he's got a good solo cut. 6'3". He's strong enough.
Shoots 60% from the free throw line. You think normally for a guard that's a low percentage, but we have seen him in this tournament, and you said this before, good players hit big shots, and we've seen him in this tournament shoot better.
Yeah, sometimes it's just really, you're unfair if you classify someone, he's only a 58 percenter, but when he gets up there with it on the line, he's more like an 85.
And Hartsock got both those rolls, and you talked about the soft rims, and I think that's probably a pretty good example right there.
Rubenstein's got nice touch on it.
So a six-point lead for the Wolves, and they've got the basketball. Udo wants to go to Mannello, but they are doing a terrific job. Brosda's fronting him and doing a nice job of it. Mannello now, and he will shoot from there, too. Mannello creating. Well, that's the guy that JV thinks has a chance to win the game, Drew Haymaker, but he couldn't quite get that one down, and here comes Bartlesville.
You know, Mannello had 35 points yesterday, 20 the first game. He's got 55 points. I thought that would be getting up close to a record, but he's quite a ways back.
Well, there have been some pretty good people playing this tournament, haven't there?
There has been outstanding players.
Rubenstein.
Got it.
So don't count anybody out yet. It's only a three-point game now, Edmund Santa Fe.
I really like what Rubenstein did then. You know, he got the ball. He was square with his shoulders. He paid no attention to the defender, just jumped it right in.
And that's five for Rubenstein. Inside to Udo. Nice little turnaround. Soft jumper for Udo. This is a guy that doesn't really look to score a lot, but J.B. Haney, you saw some elevation and a nice touch there. He's got four.
Well, when you're 6'9", you don't have to elevate yourself very much, but that was just a nice little basic turnaround jumper.
Now, if you figure out here, we're about a minute and a half to go in the first period. So if you figure at this rate, you're looking at about a 48-point game. Rubenstein down and doesn't go. Here comes Hartsock. Hartaker, pardon me. You're looking at about a 48-50-point game, and isn't that what Bartlesville wants?
They would like to keep it, say in the low 20s, even for a half, they'd like to keep it.
Long across. Now this one can get it down. He can't get this one down, though. That is Johnny Young. Nice rebound inside by Mannello. He'll go shoot a couple. Obi Mannello from the line, a 69% free throw shooter, came into this tournament averaging right at 17 a game. And as you heard J.B. Haney said, has offered more like around 27 a game in the first two. Makes that first one look easy. 6-point game now for Edmund Santa Fe. And J.B. Haney, obviously, free throws. We saw it in the girls' game right in front of us. Reese Central, unfortunately, for them, missed a good number of free throws at the end. Every game is important, but it's sure magnified right here.
It is magnified many, many times, and the winning team just has to hit what they get. They have to hit a high percent of them.
Mannello can't get the second one. Hartsock goes back to Rubenstein, and Bartlesville will set the offense just under a minute to go, first period.
Ben Rubenstein has had some good games for the Bartlesville Bruins, and you take a look at, he's a senior, and you can always expect those seniors to really step up for you.
Brandy Mays has come into the game for Edmund. There's Rubenstein again from the outside, and he got it again. Rubenstein makes it a three-point game, and he's got a couple of threes. He's got eight.
He opened the game like this, gives you a lot of confidence, and, through the tournament, Rubenstein has, he got 16 yesterday, but in the opening game, he only got 4 points.
Well, you know what? A good point guard does what his team needs, right?
That's right. And I think you can feel the necessity of him being able to hit the outside shot in order to open up the big guys inside.
Now we're under 10, and Mannello will try to create something on his own. Brosda's on him. Mannello goes off to Young, and he drops it. On the floor with it, here come the Bruins. Rubenstein, nope. That one won't go. We had a first quarter exactly like we thought we would have. Edmund Santa Fe, 13. The Bartlesville Bruins, 10. Second period coming up of the 6A Boys State Championship game. It's Ford Championship Madness here on the Cox Channel. Back at the Mabee Center, J.B. Haney, let's see some action right here.
Well, that's that inside-outside, and again, Chance Hardacre putting up the three-point, comes right back and has another good one from the outside, and they turn right around, and Ben Rovenstein does the same thing for Bartlesville. Good look, shooting right over top of the defender. Good hand up that time. He still has zeroed in right on the rim. Good play.
Taking a look at three-point shooting today, 40% for Santa Fe, 2 of 5. Bartlesville, 2 of 3 at 67%. A look there of Sam Mitchell as he comes back on the court. J.B., we really thought, I mean, everybody would think going into this that it's the Twin Towers, you know, it's Hartsock, and it's probably Manello doing most of the damage inside. And instead, we're watching the guys that don't normally get the prep, the point guards, take the points in the game.
Well, there's just a lot of strength inside on both teams. And I think in order for that to really come to surface, that you're going to have to establish something outside. And so far, Hardacre as well as Rovenstein is doing it.
Rovenstein, terrific feed to the inside, and Noah Hartsock gets that one to go. A one-point game, Santa Fe.
And did he get some good position on Udo in there? If you can get him up on your right hip on the near side, you can open up and show a good target.
That's four for now for the big guy Hartsock. 4 of 6 in the field goal so far for Santa Fe. That's how they started, 1 of 5 since that time. Udo tries it from a little bit further outside than he's used to shooting, and that one won't go, knocked out of bounds, and it'll still belong to the Bruins. So as you mentioned, you talked about Bartlesville. They don't panic, do they? They kind of work their way back in.
They just kind of go along, and they feel like that they've always got the ability to get the good spurt in the fourth quarter. And as you mentioned earlier, yesterday they got 24 points in the fourth period after going 3 periods with 21.
Ryan Waters, a bit of dribbling. Rovenstein wants the shot out to Brazda. He won't take it. Mitchell, and back out front, they'll set it all up again. A very patient basketball team is Bartlesville.
And what happens, like teams that run, sometimes if you become dominant in handling the ball, the other people do the same thing.
Hartsock looked like he had a shot. Mitchell back to him. He'll put it on the floor. He's got a nice little right hand right there. But that one's blocked. Looked like Udo got a piece of that one. On the ground, and there's the jump ball. The possession arrow goes to Santa Fe. That's an important series right there, Coach, because if Hartsock starts to think that he can't take that little right-hander, that'll change their offense.
It really would, but Udo does a great job of going up and a good clean block, and they end up with the possession, but that's just a good defensive play by Udo.
Well, Epe Udo is a 6'9" junior, and he can get up, no doubt, he can get up. Johnny Young to Udo. He's playing very confidently. The right hand won't go, though. Bartlesville comes down the floor, trailing by one. This about what you expected?
This is about what you would expect most of the time, you know, in the state championship games, regardless of records, regardless of style of plays, they normally come right down, and it goes to the wire. And I just can't, off the top of my head, Rick, remember too many games that were out of control in the championship finals.
Well, one thing to keep in mind is Chris Plank's along with us on this, and he will be talking to the coaches here going in and out of the locker room. It'll be very interesting to see what's on their mind. Rovenstein drives, takes the short jumper. That one off the front of the rim. Manello with the rebound. Now, a lot of guys, when they get a rebound, J.B. Haney, they'll turn around and they'll start to look. Obey Manello turns around and starts to run.
He does that shotgun dribble, that's what we call it, where you put it on the floor about 12 feet from where you come down. And then the next time you put it on the floor, you're at midcourt, and then you're by most of the other players, and it's a one-on-one.
Well, it makes him look like he's playing out of control, but is he really?
No, he's not out of control.
Team foul so far, Santa Fe 2, Bartlesville 3. So, again, a very well-played game. Manello. Right side to Andy Shaw. You see that shoulder we talked about, very heavily taped up.
And both teams have really settled into just half-court offense here.
And Manello would love to take it. There he goes. Manello with that three, and it won't go down, and Rovenstein will let it go out of bounds. Nice job by Rovenstein as he turns around. And right there, we may see something that affects this game. Drew Haymaker, in trying to get to that rebound, Coach, looks like he may have turned an ankle.
Well, he is putting it on the floor rather gingerly, isn't he?
Haymaker, a 6'8 junior center, and they really need that size inside. Rovenstein wanted that shot. On the drive, the right hand that goes up and down. But it's not going to count. They're going to call the offensive foul. And who takes the charge? Drew Haymaker.
Drew Haymaker has made just some real, real good plays. We'll get another good look at it here. This is a great drive by Rovenstein.
And a terrific job by Haymaker, but he is limping pretty heavily.
And that was a good call. Rovenstein that time, he went right into him. Wasn't able to move his body. Good play by Haymaker.
Shaw out front. There's Haymaker. Udo in a very unusual position for him, way up front. Well, they really want to get it to Mannello, but Brazda is doing a terrific job of fronting him.
He is harassing him, isn't he?
He is harassing him a good deal. Here goes Mannello, and he's going to go to the hole no matter what. That one knocked out of bounds. I believe that was Robenstein that got a piece of it.
Brazda's doing an excellent job. And if you deny a player just constantly harass him and not let him get his hands on the basketball, then he begins doing things that he's not accustomed to.
Hardacre wants that shot. Can't quite get it. Mannello not getting his free. Well, from way out front, Epe Udo. He's got seven already, and he is tonight's Jacob Brazda from the first round for Bartlesville.
Yes, he is, and if you won't give it to me inside, I'm going to come out and get it and knock down a three on you.
The average is 12 a game. He's already well toward that, and the Wolves lead by four. Just over four to go. Second period, boys 6A state championship game here on the Cotch Chain. Quick hands, and there is Udo. Pardon me, that is Mannello. I thought he was going to slam it. He lays it in softly.
Well, that's smart. It really upsets me to see a good basket thrown away when someone's trying to slam it instead of just making it.
So with the timeout, a six-point lead for the Edmond Santa Fe Wolves. Now watch this. Watch the quick hands, Coach.
Oh, that is a crossover dribble. You can't crossover dribble in front of someone who has the hands as quick as most of the players for Santa Fe has.
All right, one man here with us today listening in a little what's going on is Chris Plank. Let's find out what's happening over there, Chris.
Hey, thanks a lot, Rick. Just a couple of notes here real quick from the huddles early on. In the Edmond Santa Fe huddle, they were wanting to take Drew Haymaker out of the game when he was hobbling around with the ankle injury. He actually waved off coaches, taking him out of the game. Meanwhile, the Wolves are definitely focused on one guy and one guy only they feel like they need to stop to win this game, and that's Ryan Rovenstein, no question about it. Bartlesville, boy, Tim Bart is really working the officials, guys. He felt like they missed an out-of-bounds call on the last layup for Edmond Santa Fe.
All right, thank you very much, Chris Plank. Boy, it's invaluable having Chris over there able to listen to what we can't hear. And you know what? A lot of people may think there's not a lot going on in high school coaching, but these two guys are coaching their rear ends off.
Oh, there's a lot of adjustment goes on and just a lot of strategy that they bring to the game that they want to implement to win the game. But you have to respect Drew Haymaker. He doesn't want out of there, Rick.
No. And can you blame him?
No.
Drew Haymaker is only a junior, but you never know how many state championship games you're going to get to.
This is the state finals. Leave me alone.
Waters to Mitchell. And Mitchell wants to every time feed inside to Hartsock. Those two have got a little something going on. Hartsock left all alone. He'll take that shot. Can't get it to go down. And Mitchell just slaps it out of bounds. It's interesting, JV. Normally, when a guy Sam Mitchell's size gets the ball, he's looking to back down or such. He looks immediately for Hartsock, and with that ball high in the air, he makes good passes.
He really does that. Those two guys work so well together.
Mannello, and that's all you have to say. Haymaker back to Udo, who's been a kind of a secret offensive weapon tonight. So is Hardiker right there. You've seen Dennis Chance Hardiker hit a couple of nice three-point plays. Haymaker's way outside. Now, last time Udo was right about here, he took one and hit it. And here he goes. Nice pull up there, too, but he can't get it off the back of the rim, and the rebound goes to the guy who does a little everything, Ben Rovenstein. And once again, he'll slow it down. Bartlesville trailing by six with just under three to go. Second period. They are trying to correct a little bit here, aren't they, for Rovenstein. Waters with the shot from outside. That one's way under and off to the left, and it'll go out of bounds. And you'll hear Edmond Santa Fe get on him a little bit. I doubt very much that that'll bother him.
The Bruins are really trying to get Rovenstein free as much as possible. They send him down the middle, and he comes out on the far side from a double pick, or they screen out in front for him to go off the dribble.
Well, the thing that's a little unusual here today, and here comes Mannello once again, is the lack of points so far for Hartsock. Chance Hardiker won't go, and Hartsock with a rebound off the water. Hartsock with only four. Not a very typical game for him, averaging more in the area of 20.
Well, he had 19 the first day and 15 the second day.
Rubenstein will reset things, and an interesting as well. Now look at Mitchell create and get the ball to go down. Sam Mitchell, who is not normally very aggressive on offense, JB.
But he was aggressive on that one. And in a game like this, everyone has to be very aggressive. You got to put your body right against him. And he shielded himself well, kept the ball away from the defender, and was able to put it up and draw the foul.
So to the line with one shot is Sam Mitchell, a 61% free throw shooter on the year. Got a chance to bring his team within three. And he does. Just under two to go and a three-point lead for Edmond Santa Fe. And if anything has changed in high school basketball, in my opinion, it is the soft touch that players seem to have nowadays. And we've seen guys, Wayman Tisdale had it, but not as many guys had it 15 or 20 years ago that have it today.
And I think you can credit that, Rick, to the fact that most of these kids play 12 months a year. So many of them have started specializing in basketball early on. They play a great AAU schedule. Here, Barbersville now goes back to a 2-3 zone.
And Manello thinks he can get something done against that. Goes back out front. Here's the long three. No, it's not going to go. And Hartsock with the rebound. Andy Shaw can't get it to fall.
You know, a lot of coaches will go to a different defense sometime in the second quarter, just like a press. You want to see what will the team do. If I need to do it in the second half, I'd like to address it at halftime.
Quick hands by Andy Shaw knocks that one away. A little over a minute to go. 3-point lead for the Wolves. Now you see that look right there, and I think that tells you all you need to know about Drew Haymaker and what that ankle probably feels like. They've got him on the exercise bike, coach, just to keep it warm.
Yeah, just they don't want him to cool down, and he could have pulled a muscle up the leg as well.
Hartsock way out front, goes back to Brosda. Nice feed inside to Mitchell, but that one's taken away by Udo. Talk about in the air. Epe Udo way up by the rim.
And you can see just how far Udo can go up.
Oh!
I mean, goodness.
You know, there are no words to explain that. We'll just let you watch it, because that's athleticism.
Did that sound like a volleyball spike?
A little bit of that. Take a look at block Santa Fe with two. Both of those from Udo. Bartlesville none at this point. Hartsock harassed. Gets it back out to Rubenstein. Waters. Can't keep control of it, but it's knocked out, as they say, by Hardiker. And you can hear the fans with the foul on that last little push, JB.
Hardiker and Waters were really scrambling after it. The two little fellas going after it hard.
Under 30 seconds to play, a three-point game. Lob inside to try to get it to Mitchell, and it goes out of bounds. And here comes Edmond Santa Fe. I don't think that's what Tim Bart was looking for.
No, he really wasn't. I think he would like to have taken the ball with 28 seconds to go and get a real good shot, maybe tie, maybe get within one and a half, but not allow the Wolves to get another look at the rim.
So with about 23 to go, Bartlesville five turnovers, Santa Fe with one. Well, that is an important stat right there, one turnover.
Extremely important.
Under 15 seconds now, a three-point Santa Fe lead. Hardiker out front. Guess who? Obi Manella. Goes back to Hardiker. He puts up the three. Nope. And Mitchell with the rebound. Still have about 7/10 of a second to go. And the length of the court pass won't get it done. All right. We've got an 18-15 lead for Edmond Santa Fe's Wolves as we go to halftime of the 6A Boys State Championship game. Chris Plank, let's get some perspective from the bench, Chris.
All right, Coach, I know you want to get to the locker room, but your assessment of your team's performance in the first half?
We made some shots early, came out and made some threes. They made a good adjustment getting out there and covering Chance a little bit deeper. But right now we got to do something to get Obi a little more involved. They've done a really good job of just really stopping his penetration and covering the shell, not extending. We can't get him to chase us here. And, we're going to have to make a few jumpers. They're going to make us make those. And my concern is how many offensive rebounds we've got. And, I don't know if I can count them on one finger right now. So we're going to concentrate on that in the second half, try to get some putbacks. And defensively, we're guarding. And they've made a few shots. Ben made those two threes there real quick. It hurt us. But, we're excited to be here, and we're going to try to make a few adjustments and come back out second half.
Good luck, Coach. We appreciate it. Rick, JV.
All right. Thank you very much, Chris Plank. It's Edmond Santa Fe by three at the half of the 6A Boys State Championship game. We'll go back to the studio. This is Ford Championship Madness here on the Cox Channel. Pavey Center. It is a lead right now for Edmond Santa Fe, and J.B. Haney, here's what you would never have expected. An 18-15 game, all right, you might have expected that, but that Manello, with three, and Ben Hartsock only with four.
Well, I think that's a style of play that the Bruins from Bartlesville and Tim Bart really want to do. They will take you and make you play slow and keep that score down.
Let's take a look at some of how that has gone on. There is Noah Hartsock inside. One of his only four in the first half. Here's the story, Rovenstein.
And Rovenstein has got to do this throughout the game. Good penetration by Sam Mitchell drawing the foul as well.
Now on the other side of things, one of the bigger things, Chance Hardiker early on with a couple of threes.
Well, the little point guard has really done a great job for the Wolves.
And right there, Epe Udo, who we have not seen score a lot in this tournament, doing the job. And then here's Manello with two of his only three in the first half.
And that comes off of a steal with extremely quick hands.
Let's take a look at the halftime statistics. And I guess what jumps out at you right away is neither team shooting very well, 35% for Santa Fe and 38% for the Bruins.
Well, you know, the only stat there is five turnovers. When you get five turnovers by the Bruins, and that could really be the difference here. And to only be down three, I think, is very significant.
All right, let's take a look at the leading scorers. Epe Udo with seven in this game. He averages 12, so he's a little ahead of his pace. Hardiker with six, those two threes, and Manello with only three. And then J.B., Bartlesville, Rovenstein with eight. And then after that, that's really not what you'd expect from Hartsock, is it?
Well, when you only have 15 points, there's not going to be too many people scoring.
Nope.
Or 18 points as far as Santa Fe's concerned. Low-scoring games kind of keeps the good scorers' average down. But they can always break loose, and normally they do before the game's over.
Well, you know they're going to. In the 6A state championship game, it's their last shot at this for the seniors, so they're going to get after it, and the Bartlesville Bruins will inbound the ball to start the second half, down by three.
And you always feel like the first basket is so important when you get the ball starting the second half.
And Sam Mitchell once again being aggressive and right to the hole, just like in the first half, and knocks it down.
A little collision in there, but good position made by Drew Haymaker. No foul call.
And five now for Sam Mitchell. Santa Fe without front. Now, one of the stories was Drew Haymaker early in the game. Here's the steal. Rovenstein all the way with the left hand. He goes up to put it in. Ben Rovenstein now with 10.
And that is exactly what you want to do to start the second half if you're behind.
So the Bruins with their first lead in quite a while, and now the basketball with the turnover.
And it's all starting on the defensive end.
And that is certainly a frustration foul out front by Obi Manello.
And Rick, this is something that I am sure that Guy Hardiker, the coach of Santa Fe, wanted to keep this Bartlesville crowd out of the game, but they're in it now.
So Hardiker makes calls to timeout, and now the Bruins lead it by one. Chris Plank, I think it's changed a little.
Well, yeah, and Tim Bart, we didn't get a chance to talk to him on camera coming out of the locker room, but Rick and JV, I asked him a little bit about the halftime speech and what he wanted his team to do better, and right off the bat, their first two possessions, they did it. Better pressure defensively, and they did an outstanding job of getting the ball down low. He also wants to try to get Noah Hartsock to the foul line a few more times, maybe get him going that way, get him to the charity stripe, get a few easy buckets, but right now, he's preaching just defensive intensity to his team in the huddle, guys, as Bartlesville has jumped out on top here just 50 seconds into the second half.
All right, thank you very much, Chris Plank. As a matter of fact, thank you to our intrepid Stetsman, Sean. A 7-0 Bartlesville run in the last 4 minutes and 55 seconds of overall play, and you see Sam Mitchell right there. That's one of the reasons.
And that's a great anticipation and interception by Ben Rovenstein to get the second basket for Bartlesville. Thought it was very interesting, Rick, what Guy Hardiker told Chris at the half when he said he can't get Bartlesville to come out. Well, Bartlesville now is coming out, so it was kind of like playing possum. They stayed in there for 16 minutes with no pressure, and now suddenly they're jumping out in the passing lane and getting the basketball.
Right, and now if they're going to do that, you've got to go play the game you want to play. To the middle, Mitchell, Brazda, soft little left-handed jumper, and it goes. Bruins by three.
And that's a real good breaking the press. It wasn't a hard press, but you want to be aggressive on it and go score. Don't be content just to get through it.
Santa Fe now needing to calm it down a little bit. They've got to get after it. Manello trying to get open, and Brazda is just playing great defense. Inside, here's Udo. He is big in the first half with seven. He goes to Haymaker, and he got swatted. Manello from three, and it won't go. And there's Sam Mitchell, who has been very big in this game, not just at 6'9", but I'm talking about scoring and rebounding.
And I tell you something else that happens in games like this, when it's low scoring, it puts a little more pressure on you on shooting because you're not going to get as many shots.
Try the alley-oop inside to Rubenstein, out of bounds, and the Wolves will come down with it. All right, if you're Guy Hardiker right now, what are you telling your basketball team?
If what you've got to do, you've got to start taking control of the tempo if you're behind. And that has to come from the defensive end. I think that's what he was trying to do when he went to the half-court zone trap, was to take control. But he has to do that.
Here's the guy that's created a little bit. They're going to call the foul inside on Mitchell. Epe Udo trying to get the drive. He and Mitchell have really stepped up here. And they're the other big guys we really hadn't paid a lot of attention to.
You know, along the line I was talking, Rick, a lot of people don't understand it, but really when you're not getting many shots, it's harder to hit them than if you're getting them more frequently.
Here goes Manello. Nice between the legs, and that one won't fall either. Noah Hartsock with the rebound. Manello has to be getting somewhat frustrated, Coach.
Yes, he is. I mean, he's wanting to get one down, and when he hits one, watch out.
Well, he's only got three, and I'd be willing to bet there may not be another game he had three at in this at the halftime of the game. That one won't go for Rubenstein, but bounces right back to Bartlesville. Ryan Waters with the rebound.
And Brazda started that. He tipped it out real quickly, and Waters was able to tip it again.
Here's Mitchell inside again. He has taken the drive. That one's for three, and it's going to go over the back and out of play. Ryan Waters can't get it. So the Wolves will still come down with a three-point disadvantage, and they haven't scored now in about 6 minutes. And a timeout for Edmond Santa Fe. So some of what JB talked about is going to be talked about right now in that huddle. 3 points so far for Obi Manello. That's the difference in this basketball game. If you're Edmond Santa Fe, he had 35 yesterday.
Well, and you're really concerned the fact that you've opened the second half if you're Edmond Santa Fe and you've played over 2 minutes and you haven't scored yet. So you definitely are going to be talking to your kids about getting a basket, get the thing going. But anytime that you play someone, if I'm coaching the opposition with Tim Bart, and you know that you got someone as explosive as Manello, you just kind of go in fear. You know when he hits one, he may go on a streak. So you've got to do an excellent job with him, and you've got to get as much lead as you possibly can get while you can get it.
Well, and you were watching in there, you're seeing Tim Bart and a little bit of what he's saying to his team. And I think what he's saying is anytime you hold somebody to nothing over the last 6 minutes and 50 seconds, you win ball games.
Yeah, that's right, and you have a 9-0 scoring run going.
Now they're going to bring this one back again. They got started a little before everybody was ready. Of course, if you're Santa Fe, you can understand that. You want to get down here and score.
You want to get down here and score, and you want to do everything you can do to take this very partisan Bartlesville crowd out of the game.
They're actually going to let Manello bring it down and try to make something happen. Going to clear a little bit for him. Manello goes to Shaw, back to Manello, and here's Hardiker from the outside again. That one looks good, and it is. That one's way downtown, and it ties this game with under five to go in the third period.
And Hardaker gets the basket because Manello penetrated, drew the defense in. He kicks it out. He's got the good open look.
Well, we talked about Manello and his scoring, but he will dish that ball off.
Oh, yes, he will.
Brazda way out front. Rubenstein, can he answer? Nope, but he's going to get his own rebound. He goes to Waters, and back out front, and they'll set it up.
Rubenstein's doing an excellent job of running this basketball team now.
Well, you know, you watch him, and he'll take the ball, and he'll just stop for a second, and that's important to get everybody to stop. Noah Hartsock, what a feed inside, and Hartsock's all alone. He's got six.
That's that little backdoor pick, and a great move in there, but Rubenstein set it up.
So the Bruins go back up by two. Manello to the center. He's going to take it all the way, and that was partially blocked. And Manello follows his own rebound. And, Coach, there's that basket you're talking about. That's his fifth point.
That's it, and that's what we saw him do so much of yesterday. Let's see if he continues to do it.
There's the steal by Hardiker. Coast to coast, nice off left hand, and the lead goes back to Edmond Santa Fe. Well, you may think you're watching tennis, but you're not.
No, and it can happen just that quickly.
11 now for Hardiker.
And it seems like good defense is always predicated on good offense.
And Hardiker averages only around 7.5. Nice job by the steal, and here comes Manello. Now, that's a pretty good foul out front, isn't it, by Rubenstein?
That's an excellent foul by Rubenstein out in front, because when you do that, you saved yourself 2 points. And I've always said, if a foul can save a point, hey, that is that's a good foul. It's not wasted.
Well, the other point to make here is you talked about Mannello. If he gets that shot, if he gets the slam, which he might get right there, that might start his game.
Absolutely, it would. So, Ben Rubenstein that time took the foul very worthwhile.
Mannello on the drive, can't get the right hand down. Good defense inside, good help defense by Hartsock, and he has the rebound. That's what you want to see, isn't it, Coach? The guy dropping down.
Yeah, absolutely. You got to drop back in there and then make absolutely sure they only get one shot.
Brazda, he will not take that shot very often. But Rubenstein will take this one. Mitchell with a terrific rebound, but a really good job by Drew Haymaker to get inside and tie him up. Now the arrow goes back to Santa Fe. There's your guy, Drew Haymaker, with a smart play.
Very smart play. The big men are really going tough to the glass. Now, there's a little bumping and grinding going on, but as long as you're not shoving, if it's body contact, I think you have to let them play. Officials doing an excellent job.
They are doing a great job. We'll name those guys a little later on. Well, there's a whistle right there by one of J.B. Haney's former players.
Ira Willis, a graduate of Webster High School, and I've said this many a times about Ira. If I ever had a game in which you needed one basket, one shot, I'd let him shoot it. Or if you were batting, I want him to take the last man. Outpost, Ira Willis and Irvin Wilson.
We did a good job today. Here comes Mannello from the top of the key, and he's got that one to go. JV said he'd heat up, and he just has. He makes it a 5-point Edmund Santa Fe advantage.
Anytime you hold a good player in check the way they did the first half, why, you know that sooner or later he's going to break loose.
Early whistle there, and they call the timeout. Now, that is a young man right there, Johnny Young, who averages about 5.5 a game and was very good yesterday. Haven't heard much from him today, and he's got a, looks like an ankle.
You just really hate to see a youngster come down with any kind of an injury, and Johnny, especially a senior, state championship game, playing, having fun, memory for a lifetime. Then he turned an ankle.
Trying to walk it off. Now you're going to bring in number 11, Andy Shaw. And again, you'll see that very heavy arm wrap on him. Sam Mitchell thought about it. Noah Hartsock, nice job back outside. And we'll start all over again. Brazda will look. And he'll take that one maybe. Nope. His face. And here comes Chance Hardiker once again with the steal. And once again with a soft left hand. And now a 7-point advantage for Edmund Santa Fe. And Hardiker has 13.
Well, you know, I said a few minutes ago how that Chance Hardiker is like having a coach on the court. He has the play figured out. And he's laid over there twice and just let his man go and waited on the pass coming back to Rubenstein. Good play.
Well, we said Jacob Brazda won't take that three very often, but he just took that one and he knocked it down. 29% normally from three, but Brazda brings his team back within four. Just over a minute to go, third period, 6A boys state championship game, and it's everything we thought it might be. Way out front is Haymaker. Will Santa Fe play for the last shot here, or are they just going to dribble it around? Nope. Well, with this guy, you never know. Mannello. Terrific move inside and soft off the glass, and he did heat up, J.B. Haney.
Well, you knew it was going to come because he's too good of a player, and if you go outside and try to stop him, he's going to penetrate on you. Of course, if you don't go, he hits a three, so what do you do?
Well, not a whole lot you can do. He's in double figures now. Brazda inside to Hartsock. A spin move, but he can't get it to go down, and the reason... Udo with the block, but they're going to call him with a foul. Looked like body contact, maybe.
Little body contact in there, really was. Maybe he got him on the elbow going up as well.
Oh, yeah.
No doubt.
Yeah, it's harder to shoot when the guy's hanging on your elbow, isn't it?
It's difficult.
To the free throw line, Noah Hartsock shoots 75% from there. Kind of a unique motion over the head. But when it goes like that, I don't care how you shoot it.
Good soft release, isn't it?
You know, and I've heard a lot of coaches, J.B. Haney, talk about whether or not you fix, quote-unquote, fix a guy's shot that looks like that. To me, if he's hitting it, I'm going to let him shoot it.
I have never changed the shot. You can teach new ones, But if a kid comes up and he gets into high school and he's got some kind of a little quirk on his shot, forget it. I don't think you can change it.
So the Wolves up by five. We're under a half minute to go, third period. Chance Artiker from way out front.
And now they're going to take the last shot.
Let's just see who takes it. All right, now we're under 10. Time to play a little offense.
Udo's wanting the ball down low.
Way downtown, not quite good enough. Andy Shaw has another shot. And that one just bounces out. Well, you might say like Pat Jones used to, it's hang on to your hat time. We got a 5-point game. Edmund Santa Fe in the lead going to the fourth quarter of the 6A Boys State Championship game. Don't touch that dial. We know where you live. It's for Championship Madness here on the Cox Channel. Well, I hope you're back from the refrigerator because you do not want to go anywhere in the fourth period of this game. 8 minutes to go, and someone is going to have a gold ball with a net around it. Rick Corey and J.B. Haney here on the Cox Channel. Edmund Santa Fe up by five on the Bartlesville Bruins, and J.B. Haney, most of Bartlesville is right behind us.
I tell you what, they did bring entire Washington County, I think. It's going to be interesting, Rick. This is relatively a low-scoring game when you look 32-27 Santa Fe. That's normally low-scoring. And what will happen here in the last 8 minutes? Will one of them suddenly start to play conservative? Will Santa Fe want to play conservative? Or are you going to take it to Monroe and just turn him, don't turn him loose? What would you do?
Well, I'm telling you, I don't stop playing the game. Anytime you play not to lose, you lose.
That's right. So look for Manello just to keep on going.
I would think so. He can sure make a coach look like a smart guy, can he? Rubenstein out front to Waters. They still want to get it inside the Hartsock, and they can't. Mitchell inside, and that was taken by Manello, but I think they're going to call Udo. A little pushing and shoving going on in there.
Well, there was a little wrestling match going on in there.
Three fouls on Udo, and JB, that can be an important thing.
It really could.
Taking a look at the scoring, Santa Fe winning the first and the third periods, but not by a lot, and of course, almost nothing in the second period. They score five apiece. Mitchell back to Rubenstein. He'll take that one. Not quite, and terrific position by Udo. Had Sam Mitchell right on his elbow and did a nice job. Here comes Manello. You cannot get any softer off the glass than that.
You know, he's got such, hang time, I guess is what you'd have to call it. He goes and he lets you go by, and then he puts it up with the softest feather touch.
12 points now for Manello. Mitchell once again looking to feed. That one knocked away, and Manello will come with it. He sends everybody down court. And we talked about how many Bartlesville are behind us, JV. 14 businesses closed yesterday to allow people to come down here. And get this stat. You've been an educator all your life. 302 parents signed their children out to be down here yesterday.
Well, you know, I think that's wonderful when that happens, because let the student body be a part of the experience of winning a state championship or the experience of losing it. It's still a great experience.
Drew Haymaker had that miss, and so with the 7-point lead, Edmund Santa Fe will defend the Bruins. Brian Waters, Rubenstein wanted it, couldn't quite get it up. Out front again, this one down low, knocked away. And again, you see Mitchell, JV, look immediately for Hartsock when he gets the basketball.
Well, that high-low worked so well for them over the years, but they're getting some help from the far side. That time it was Chance Hardacre coming in. Before that, they were getting it out of Johnny Young. So they're really getting some good help out of the corners over there.
And there's the steal. Here comes Santa Fe. Rodney Island. And there are bodies everywhere under the basket.
And what a play by Rovenstein. He was going out of bounds, turned in midair, and threw it off one of the Santa Fe players. Oh, what a play that was. Threw it off of Chance Hardacre.
You know, there really aren't words for that, so just watch it. That's just a terrifically smart play by Rovenstein. Just over 6 minutes to go, a 7-point Edmund Santa Fe lead. The winner's got a pretty sweet bus ride home. Manello very tight. Going for the steal there is Island. Drives to inside. Oh, that one rejected again. Noah Hartsock has had that happen a couple of times. Udo. And then Manello steps on the line. How important has Udo been, JV, in not just blocking shots, but changing shots?
Oh, he has just been phenomenal on both ends, really. But I want you to look at the call here by Urban Wilson, the official. He's going down on the break, but he was turning and looking back. One of the good young officials. Played for John Phillips over at Edison High School.
There you go. Three blocks for you today, and all three have been very big ones. Bartlesville has one. Rubenstein back to Mitchell. Well, these big guys are well coached. They do not bring the ball down very much.
But we are looking at two well-coached teams, aren't we?
There's no doubt about that. Now, Hartsock wants to create. Little fadeaway. Not there. Up in the air, and it comes back to Brazda. Boy, he's a tough little guy.
Tell you what, he just almost goes unnoticed, but he's a lot like Drew Haymaker for Santa Fe. He's in there around the action all the time.
Hartsock to Waters. Hardiker again after the steal, and that time he gets the foul. Hardiker has been a big, big part of this ball game. The average is only 7.5, but he's already in double figures.
Well, his defense has just been superb. The anticipation, and a lot of that comes from a good scouting report and rehearsing that scouting report where you feel like you really know what the people are going to do against you.
And he has sat on a couple of those, hasn't he? He's just sat there and waited for them.
Yes, he has. Invited it, as a matter of fact.
Here's Rubenstein. Got that feed inside. Hartsock can't get it down, but he'll get the foul. That time it's going to be called on Rodney Island. And both these teams, JV, we talked about it, not a lot of fouls called here today. Neither one still in the bonus. So they're both really putting themselves in good situation.
Six fouls and three fouls. That's not very many. And I think, let's credit the officials for doing that. They're not calling the little ticky-tack fouls. They're calling those that have an implication to affect the game.
And that one thrown away by Bartlesville, and Tim Barton wants to talk about it. 7-point lead for Edmond Santa Fe. We are just at three ticks under 5 minutes to go in the 6A Boys State Championship game. Across from us, where he can hear the coaches, is Chris Plank. What are you hearing, Chris?
Well, bottom line is Bartlesville really wanted to use the backdoor play more when they came out of the halftime locker room through the third quarter. It didn't happen. Kind of over here right now, Tim Bark just urging his guys to keep working, stay patient. I mean, the problem here, Bartlesville's had some decent looks, but they just haven't been able to finish. Meanwhile, on the Edmond Santa Fe side, as you can imagine, the passion's pretty high, and if you can't tell, the fans are into it in a big-time way. The coaching staff has been adamant all game long to maintain the defensive pressure, guys.
All right, we appreciate that. Thank you very much, Chris Plank, adding invaluable sideline insight over there, because, JB, we can't hear those guys as much. Now, Guy Hardiker, you're seeing him in his huddle right now. He really had a little bit of a problem, had some struggle last year, but he has really come out of it. Take a look at some of Manello's offense. Oops.
Some three. If you back off from him, he hits that three. You get up on him, he goes by you.
And again, we talked about the soft touch. Just watch.
What great acceleration. And then he goes right back between two defenders.
You know what I've been impressed with so far, honestly, JV, by the half when he only had three, and so he's got nine here in the second, I really thought he might get frustrated, push a little bit, and then not play as well, and that never showed on him.
No, it really didn't, and that's the quality of a good player. It's like I say this on fouls. Good players can play with four fouls. Good players won't get frustrated if things don't go their way for a while because they know it will come back.
Well, it has done that. He's got his team right now a 7-point lead with under 5 minutes to play. 6A Boys State Championship game. Chance Hardiker out front, and there's Manello again. Just dribbling through four or five people. Ball turned over. Haymaker not able to handle it.
Ben Rubenstein was the one who deflected that out.
Now, JV, we talk about possessions an awful lot. When you're under five and you're 4.5 to go, obviously basketball is a different sport. There's Mitchell with a soft right hand. Gets his own rebound. Tries to do it again, knocked away. And then Mitchell knocks it away. Everybody says it's going the other way. Edmond Santa Fe will have it. Back to my point, possessions-wise, do you start to think about that now as a coach?
Yeah, you start to think about it really about the six-minute mark. You're beginning to think about it. But with the three-point shot, why, it's not as crucial as it was several years ago. But, yes, they are thinking about it. And I think right now we're seeing this with Edmond Santa Fe. They're going to kill a few ticks off the clock. The coach horned them out. He's going to get them out now.
Yep. And they have no choice but to come out.
They have to come out.
I don't think Udo's the guy you want out here, though.
And I sure don't want number 32 out there in the green.
No. And Johnny Young is back in the game, by the way, as well. Here's a guy that really created a lot of things last night. Hasn't had much happen for him tonight, but he left with the ankle, and now he's back, so watch him. Chance Hardiker way outside. And here's Manello. Might as well just watch this because we probably don't have words to describe it. Yep, I was right.
And that's exactly what happens. He pulls you out, and he's going to get by the first wave. And then when you get the weak side help coming over, if you're not established, and that time for sure Sam Mitchell was not established, then you get the foul, and of course, Manalo, he'll make the basket.
Well, and he takes off from three quarters of the way up the free throw line and then glides down and adjusts his body, protects himself with the left arm. He's got 14, a chance to make it 15 here. He's got it. And he's put his team up by 10 with 3.5 to go.
Now, this becomes a very serious situation for Tim Bard and the Bruins. They have to score now on every possession. They can't have any dry runs.
The story of this game so far has been the defense that Santa Fe has played on that man right there, Noah Hartsock. Way outside, Rubenstein, no good, but Mitchell with the rebound. Here's Water. Got it. That's what you talked about, Coach. That three-point play can sure make it a different ballgame.
It really can, and, you know, one more defensive stop and one more three, and now you're right back in the ballgame. But you have to score on every possession in this situation.
Well,
and you're not going to shut out Santa Fe. They're going to get some in between.
Manalo. That's just about everybody on him. And he doesn't seem to care. We watched him, of course, Manalo, very good with the left-handed dribble, Coach, and that's not always the case with a right-handed guy.
You know, when you look at their talent, they could really let their eye out on you if you wanted to.
Well, at what point do you do that? At what point do you say play your game? Manalo can't get that one down. Here's Hartsock.
You know, I don't know what they've done all year long, but whatever you've done, don't change it. Right. If you have done this in the past, then do it. If you've played to the end, keep playing. Don't change anything at this point.
Just over two to go, a 7-minute lead for Edmond Santa Fe. Rubenstein been a big part of this game. Mitchell. And Rubenstein again. Had the shot, passed it up. Here comes Mitchell. Gets his own rebound, and he's going to put that one back. We're in a five-point game, just under two to go. He's got seven.
And now this is where the defensive stop. You start saying as a coach, Rick, give me one more. One more defensive stop.
Udo way out front. Haymaker. I don't believe Udo scored in the half. But this guy has, Obi Manalo, being looked at as a junior by just about every college that plays basketball in the country. Epi Udo looked like the Bartlesville fans thought maybe he crossed the line. Instead, it was Edmond Santa Fe calling a timeout.
No, we're looking right down the line. He did not cross the line, but I'm sure those that were setting off center a little bit thought maybe he had done it.
One tick, under a minute and a half to go. It's a five-point lead for Edmond Santa Fe. And just so you'll know, in case of tie-up, right now, Edmond Santa Fe has the possession arrow.
That's the nice shot outside. That's a big basket by Ryan Waters. That brought him from 10 points down, and then they come right around, and big Sam Mitchell gets his own rebound. Good up hard, down hard. That clicked off five of the 10 points very quickly, didn't it?
Now tell us, J.V. Haney, why or how Edmond has had such success defending Noah Hartsock.
Well, they've got two big guys in there. I think Udo is the big reason why they've been able to do this. And keep in mind, Drew Haymaker in there, a very smart player. So they match up in there. You're just not going to run wild. They're not going to be able to take the ball like they have been against smaller players on the schedule. And this has been just a good matchup with those four people inside.
All right, here's your game reset. 37-32, five fouls for Santa Fe, four for Bartlesville, neither team in the bonus. Two timeouts for the Wolves, three for the Bruins, and here we go. Obi Manalo backcourt with Jacob Bronson guarding.
And that important jump ball era is in Santa Fe's favor. You mentioned, Rick, and that could be monumental here.
It could be. Chance Hardiker out front with Waters on him. Goes to Udo. Udo guarded by Big Sam. And a big mistake by Drew Haymaker. Stepped out of bounds, and he did have about half the heel out on the line.
Yes, he did. That was a good call by Al Post, and, you know, he's the one we haven't talked about, but a veteran official and certainly one of the Metropolitan Area of Tulsa's best officials. You can see it right there.
Yep, see it right there.
No doubt about that one.
So Bartlesville down by five, a minute to play in the state championship game, 6A.
And it doesn't make any difference. You need a three and a two, so whichever one comes first is what you take.
Take the best shot. Mitchell out front. Goes back, and the ball's knocked away. Edmond Santa Fe with the steal, and that's number 50.
Whoa.
That is Hardiker. Sorry. Now look the other way. It was Chance Hardiker.
Did the same thing. He sat back in on defense and expecting the ball to come to Rubenstein, and he picked it off.
And Epe Udo goes down. If you have to have a foul, I guess you might as well make it a good one, huh, Coach?
Yes. And we'll get a good look at here. And you see him just sitting in there. You know, the three steals that that young man has made was as important as any three baskets made by any of the other players. They were big.
And two of those, of course, led directly to fast break layups. And now Bartlesville will call will foul Jacob Brosda with a foul, and he fouls Menudo. Or Manello, pardon me. Menudo. I'm thinking of singers. Wow.
Well, we've had too many different names and too many different teams in the last 3 days. Rick, it's a wonder we know each other's name.
Six fouls for Bartlesville now and five for Santa Fe. We're going to call that one way out front. And obviously, JB, you have to get into this game now, don't you?
Yes, you do. You know, I'm just sitting here reflecting back. This is more like old-time basketball.
Mm-hmm.
It has not been the transition. It hadn't been coast-to-coast throwing long. They have both taken the ball, played good half-court offense, great half-court defense, hit crucial shots. It's been a great basketball
game. Chance Hardiker gets his own rebound, misses the free throw and gets his own rebound, but then creates the foul down underneath. Chance Hardiker has done everything for Edmond Santa Fe today. So with just over 30.3 seconds to go is what we have left. It's still a five-point game, and the Bruins will have the basketball. And what are they thinking? I mean, so far, you only have 7 points for Noah Hartsock, who averages nearly 20. What do you think? Well, let's find out what they're thinking over there. Chris Plank, what do you hear?
Well, Rick, right now it's just a matter of Bartlesville getting in the huddle. Tim Bard had a couple of things he wanted to say to Noah Hartsock before they got sat down. But the bottom line is don't give up. There's only 30 seconds left, but they still want to fight through. They feel like they have a shot in this game, and why not? Meanwhile, Edmond Santa Fe, you can imagine the frustration with the chance to pretty much ice this game away on the line. They're just reassuring the fact that this game is not over right now. You see Tim Bard in the huddle there. Meanwhile, the Edmond Santa Fe huddle, it's don't let up. Don't give up. This game is not over yet, guys.
All right, and Chance Hardiker is normally a 64% free throw shooter, but he couldn't get that one to go. J.B. Haney, what are you going to set up here for Bartlesville?
Well, I'm sure that Bartlesville is trying to determine if they have to foul, who they are going to foul. Sometimes you can't carry through with that because the guy you want to foul doesn't get the basketball. But again, they're stressing. They've got to score when they get the ball. They've got to score quick. They've got to get a timeout, get the clock stopped, set their defense, and then you've just got to play just absolutely lights out basketball here for 30 seconds.
All right. Here's the reset once again. We've got a five-point game. Santa Fe in the lead. Six fouls for the Wolves, seven for Bartlesville. Both have two timeouts. And right now, the possession arrow goes to the Wolves of Edmond Santa Fe. Bartlesville's going to inbound the ball.
And this is a good move by Edmond Santa Fe. Come up, and I don't know how hard the pressure will be, but get that clock started down here 90 feet from the basket.
Ball into Mitchell and right back to Water. So it won't be a lot of pressure, but J.B. Haney, you get about 5 seconds out of that.
That's right. You've got a few ticks off the clock.
Waters to Mitchell, way out front. There's Brosda. Inside, Hartsock. Good body position, and he gets it down. So a three-point game now.
And immediately Ryan Waters goes in and gets a foul on Chance Hardiker.
Well, and Hardiker, again, is a guy who shoots 64%. If you look at Santa Fe, let's watch the replay first of all and see the nice feet and the terrific body position by Noah Hartsock.
Yeah, not nice screen freeing up and delivering the ball inside.
Now, if you look at the percentages, free throw percentages for Edmond Santa Fe, only Haymaker, who shoots 80%, is really truly an outstanding free throw shooter. You've got 64% for Hardiker and Shaw. Udo at 61%. Manello at 69%. Johnny Young at 45%. So as long as you don't foul Haymaker, you got a decent shot at it.
Well, that's true. And you know, this is a lot of pressure. He just needs one. If he can get one down, why, that puts it a two possession. Awful difficult to do with less than 12 seconds on the clock.
Well, yesterday, of course, in the semifinal game, Edmond Santa Fe, a winner over Putnam City, and the reason is because coming down court in a situation just like this, Obi Manella was able to knock one down.
I mean, and I can see that one still, Rick, right in front of us, how he was able to get through the traffic and then put it down from the way he was going horizontal across the court. It was a remarkable shot.
All right, if the last 11.8 seconds stays like this, if Edmond Santa Fe wins this game, what is the story of the game for Santa Fe?
Well, you know, everyone will see it through different eyes. I see it, number one, I see it through Chance Harker's three defensive steals that turned into 4 points, and that can be the difference. Also, the fact that Manello came alive in the second half. I thought UDU really did a good job from top to bottom, maybe not scoring as much, did a good job with the blockouts. He did a good job on defending the big men inside and keeping them pretty much contained. I mean, it really was, as far as I'm concerned, that's a team effort for Santa Fe.
Well, Udo's a big part of this. He had three big blocks and a couple of those on what could have been easy baskets, and then had the seven in the first half that really kept his team alive. Here we go. Let's see if Chance Harker can make this a four-point game. And he does. Boy, there's not a more pressure free throw for that young man than he just shot right there. Well, there's about to be, and it's the next one, isn't it?
Well, and they immediately call timeout. And now is when you go over everything you have ever been taught about don't do something foolish. And don't think for a minute that Coach Hardacre is not going through whatever he feels that could happen and warning his kids not to do it.
Well, as a matter of fact, that's what he's doing in his huddle right now over in Tim Bart's side. What he's probably telling his team is, let's take the first great shot and foul somebody, right?
Immediately. And you know, most people have some type of a fast break off a missed free throw. Now, you don't get to run it every time, but hopefully you could get the rebound. If they miss it, you run your break, you get your basket, call timeout. You still may have 5 seconds left, 4 seconds. A lot can happen, and you got to tell your kids that. They got to believe in it.
Let's hear from Tim Bart and see what he's saying.
Hey, secondary, same place. Run the play, really good. That's what it's all about. Ain't no fouls, these things are 4 points late. Have a lot of time. All right, execute right here. Execute.
You know, and one thing he said right there that I love, his team's down by four with 11.8 to go. And what does he say? This is what it's all about. And he's right. That's what it's all about.
And he also mentioned four-point play. We see it a lot. And that's what that Coach Hardacre was talking about with Santa Fe. Don't you dare foul on a three-point shot. But you've told kids that, and what have they done? They go do it.
It's happened. All right, here's Chance Hardacre's biggest free throw of his career thus far. Under 12 to go. His team leads by four. And now by five. And he has just made it a lot more difficult for Bartlesville.
And now it's academic.
Here comes Waters. Got it to Hartsock. Puts up the running two. I think it's a two. Yeah, and he did get the two to fall. I cannot believe the body position he was in when he hit that shot.
No, that was a remarkable shot. And you know, again, you tell your kids all Santa Fe had to do was to hold the ball out of bounds because the clock doesn't start in high school ball. And there was about 4 seconds when it went through. Now there's a half a second left.
Well, you say this about Rovenstein, though. That is a terrific shot, and that's his 13th point of the game. And who goes to the line? Johnny Young, the worst free throw shooter out there for Edmond Santa Fe at 45%. Matter of fact, he shoots 43% from the field and 45% from the free throw line, so there's not a great difference. But that one looked pretty easy.
He really didn't bat an eye on that one, did he?
Not any trouble at all. 3-point game with half a second to go.
Well, he's had 24 points coming into today's game in the two tournament games he's played, so he's confident.
That one won't go, and here come the Bruins. And that will do it. In only their third state tournament appearance, the Edmond Santa Fe Wolves are the 6A boys state champions. J.B. Haney, the Santa Fe Wolves got their first ever tournament win this year. And now they're the state champion.
And the first ever state championship. What a thrill it is. And, you know, you've just got to be delighted for those kids because they've set a precedence at Santa Fe. From now on, they can look back and tell those youngsters coming up, we did it.
All right, let's hear what the winning coach has to say right now. Guy Hardacre with Chris Plank.
All right, Coach, congratulations. State championship. Can you even capsulize how you feel?
Well, I tell you what I was thinking about. In 93, I was an assistant coach for Edmond Memorial, and Mike De La Garza was the head coach. We beat Bartlesville. J.R. Cunningham made two foul shots with 4 seconds to win the game. And I remember my son was this tall, and they wouldn't let him on the floor at the Mabee Center. So I told my wife, I said, you got to put him on the floor no matter what if we win. I said, because he's got to know what this feels like so that he'll remember it and feel it once again.
It had to be pretty special whenever he made those two free throws in at the end.
I'm real proud of him, you know, but I tell you what, if some of our guys, our marquee guys like Obi and Epe, and some of those guys aren't, their presence aren't out there, then he doesn't get those opportunities. So, you know, we're very blessed with a group of great kids and a great coaching staff. And as you hear, our student body.
Great fans.
It's unbelievable.
All right, Coach, congratulations. Go enjoy it.
Thank you.
A great story, guys. He wanted his kid to know what it was like to hit a clutch shot. In this game, he did tonight.
Well, as a matter of fact, Chris Plank, 15 points tonight for Chance Hardiker, exactly double his average. And then, JV, can you describe what he must be feeling when he walks up to those last two free throws?
Well, I know. I can imagine in his mind, there was no way he was going to miss them. He's going to drop those in there. Kids dream about those. They go out and shoot in the driveway, and they play this like they're a radio announcer, Rick. You know, 2 seconds to go. I'm down two. I've got to hit it. And I'm sure that was going through his mind.
And all those dreams come through for Edmond Santa Fe. By the way, all 5 starters for Edmond Santa Fe are juniors. So if you're watching them in the state playoffs next year, and I got to think they'll be there, you should be watching all these same players, Coach.
Well, I think they will be back. Now, to say whether they'll repeat, that's always questionable. But one thing for sure, I think they will be back in the state tournament. And as I said a while ago, this is how traditions really get started. When you get a good young group and they come and win one, they like it, they want to experience again next year.
Well, on the other side of things, you have to feel for Tim Bart. He and Bartlesville come into this thing with a number 1 ranking according to the Tulsa World, with a terrific player in Noah Hartsock. But today, they just never could get the inside game on track.
Well, they had 2 big guys that we talked about in there. You do, and of course, Manello, Drew Haymaker. Those guys are just tough inside, and you can't just really run wild. But I thought it was the type of game that Coach Bart would pretty much want, a low-scoring game. He got a great play out of Ben Rovenstein this afternoon. Jacob Brasda as well did a good job besides Hartsock and Mitchell. Ryan Walters hits a big basket. So he didn't have the depth maybe that he wanted, but he has nothing to hang his head down. There's 30 teams out there, Rick, that would love to be experiencing a loss here this afternoon to Mabee Center.
And Ben Rovenstein really was his key in this basketball game. When Hartsock couldn't get on track, it was Rovenstein that kept him in the ballgame.
And I thought the guard play on both sides was just remarkable this afternoon. And that's what you expect in a state championship game, and we certainly did see it this afternoon.
Well, and if you take a look at Bartlesville as well, Sam Mitchell's a senior, but Hartsock is a junior. He'll be back. Rovenstein will be gone. So will Waters. Brasda, though, is a junior, so they've got a decent group coming back as well. Let's go to the PA system, and we're going to listen as they present the runner-up and the championship trophies here for 6A.
Brian Jenkinson. Ross Moore. Kermit Reese. Taylor Doe. Markel Carter. Kyle Kemp. Jason Pitts. Jacob Brasda. Noah Hartsock. Ryan Waters. Ben Rovenstein. And Sam Mitchell. At this time, we'd like to recognize Bartlesville Bruin coach Tim Bart with the Coach's Achievement Plaque.
Tim Bart receiving the plaque from the coaches. They'll give them the silver ball, JV. It's not the gold one, but it's not bad.
Well, it's kind of an empty feeling when you get that silver ball, and it takes a couple of 3 days for it to settle in. And then you look back, and as I said a while ago, you have to appreciate the great year the kids gave you, because you did have an opportunity to go right to the wire on it. And when you only lose by three in the finals, I don't think you have anything to be ashamed of.
And a nice job by the Bartlesville fans to turn out and support their team, and not only the Bartlesville fans, but the Santa Fe fans as well. And now it's time to start handing out some hardware on the other side for the state champions in 6A, Edmond Santa Fe.
Assisting with the presentation will be high school principal Vicki Simpson, district athletic director Mike Nunley, building athletic director Mark Meads, and superintendent Dr. David Gowen. If our state champion Santa Fe Wolves will step up as their name is called, J.M. Palovic. Kevin Blackman. Andy Shaw. Nick Combs. Chance Hardacre. Eddie Schmidtick. Epe Udo. Tyler Grubb. Johnny Young. Victor Seidel. Obi Manello. Rodney Island. Joy Atkinson. Brandy Mays. Andrew Haymaker. And now a coach's achievement plaque and also a Wilson autograph basketball to the coach of the state champion Wolves, Guy Hardacre. Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the 2005 Class 6A gold ball to Edmond Santa Fe Wolves.
Well, there you see it, Edmond Santa Fe hoisting the gold ball. Take a look at the stats, J.B. Haney, and they are very close for most of this game. Rebounds a little to the edge of Bartlesville, but everything else pretty close.
Well, I think their turnover ratio there maybe was what, 13-7 was the difference, but everything else was just about as close as you would expect a three-point game.
Chris Plank is with the coach that didn't win this game, Tim Bartlesville.
All right, Tim, congratulations on the great season. This was a game tonight where you guys had chances. I know, though, you're still proud of the guys' effort.
Oh, I wouldn't trade him for any player in the state. Outstanding effort. We're not a bunch of great athletes, but we're a good basketball team. We got basketball players that know how to compete, and they're very coachable. And you know what? They're better kids off the floor than they are players. And I'll take a bunch like that any day.
And obviously you have a great group coming back next year, but still this has got to be hard for the seniors.
Yeah, it's tough. These guys have won a lot of games in their career, and they helped establish and bring Bartlesville back to the old days, and I couldn't be more excited and happy for them and our community.
Good job. Congratulations on getting to the finals. Good luck next year.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
All right, guys. Tim Bart, humble in defeat and gracious to come and hang out with us.
All right. Thanks very much, Chris Plank. So Edmond Santa Fe, the 6A boys state champion, but don't go away. There's much more. We'll take it to the studio. It's Ford Championship Madness here on the Cox Channel.